to the MERS quad rotor test bed. The purpose of this test bed is to demonstrate the Boeing PTS scenario in hardware, as well as to enable multimodal user interaction. This includes speech, as well as body and hand gestures. The test bed consists of these ARDrone quad rotors, as well as Kinect sensors mounted across the ceiling. Each Kinect sensor has a field of view covering a certain portion of this test bed. So, as long as the quad rotor stays within this test area, we can sense the quad rotor's position. As you can see, we have a fairly wide area in which to operate the ARDrone. Now, the Kinect sensors their purpose is to monitor the position of the quad rotor, while the quad rotor itself has a IMU on board to estimate the orientation. We've built a Kalman filter system that fuses the information from all the sensors to produce a pose estimate. The Kalman filter is seamless in that if we transition the quad rotor from one field of view to another sensor's field of view, it will not affect the pose estimate at all. Now, once we have the pose estimate, we apply a PID controller to control the quad rotor's position within this test environment. In later videos, what you'll see is this quad rotor taking off from the ground, and we can control it via keyboard commands manually. However, we can also acquire a lock on it, after which the PID controller is activated, and then the rest will follow.
Okay, so next I'm going to show you how the Kinect location system actually works with our quadcopter. As you can see, this is a major user interface we have. So each Kinect, the image from each Kinect will be displayed here. So the Kinect number 1, 2, then 3 and 4. So and we also show all the detection data here as numbers like the current location and our target location. So next, I will start flying the quadcopter now. So as you can see, there is a purple cross here that marked on the quadcopter. It is the current location detected by the Kinect network. So once I take off, so as you can see, the quadcopter is actually flying now. So the location system keeps tracking the quadcopter no matter where it flies to. So this is in the range of Kinect 4. Come back to Kinect 3. And go to Kinect 2. I can see it's here now. So this still under the manual control mode. As Andrew told you before, we also have a PID controller that can lock the quadcopter at one specific position. As you can see, right now I'm moving the right circle, basically the target region now. So let me lock the position. I just need to move the cross into the center of the target region. And as you can see, the quadcopter can stabilize itself now. So it's quite stable, so it doesn't do much intense maneuver. So right now I don't need to give it any manual input anymore. I can just simply move the target region and the quadcopter will follow me. Move downward, to the right, to the left. I can also move to the area of the other Kinect. As you can see, it's pretty stable. Moving further. Come back. So basically, we can have the quadcopter run between the range of four different Kinects without losing any without losing the location data. And it also works pretty well with our PID controller, as you can see, it's really stable. So we can also show the quadcopter, I think. Yeah. I'm moving a little bit more to the right, to the back. Finally, so basically this is how the Kinect sensor works, and this is the user interface. Okay, so next I will show you a demo of the PTS scenario and the quadcopter. So right, basically we have, sorry, can I restart? I just realized. Okay. So next, I'm going to show you a demo. We integrate the quadcopter testbed with the original PTS demo. So what you're going to say is I'm talking to the quadcopter and telling the quadcopter where I would like to go, and it will just go there automatically. So still, we have the monitor or user interface for the Kinect, for Kinect, and we have the localization system running. And in addition to that, we also have Kirk coordination, the coordinator, and PSU running behind the scene. So basically, we will through the dialog manager, I will input my plan. Kirk will reason through the input plan and either propose explanation or start execution. And later, it will pass all the information to PSU, and PSU will plan a path. And the quadcopter will just follow the path given by PSU to the destination. Okay, so next, I will just start talking to the dialog manager. This is Tom.
Authorization confirmed.
Let's go to Harvey Field.
Any other requirements?
I want to be there in 3 minutes.
Anything else? There is a small storm between Sanderson Field and Harvey Field.
I want to fly over Leisureland.
Any more preferences?
I want to fly over Kingston Airport.
So your waypoints are Leisureland and Kingston?
Yes.
Anything else?
No.
So you want to get to Harvey Field in 3 minutes with waypoints at Leisureland and Kingston?
Yes.
Okay. I have a valid plan.
That's fine.
Okay.
Now, as you can see, I have finished input plan through the dialog manager, and after Kirk evaluated the feasibility of the plan, the copter has started flying. As you can see on the screen, all the waypoints generated by PSUDO are transmitted into the quadcopter control panel. So basically, here you can see this is a point corresponding to the point generated by PSUDO displayed on the coordinator. And the quadcopter will just follow the path given by PSU fly to the destination. And that's the end of the PTS demo.
Right, we're going to show you how we can use the Kinect system to detect body pose in order to offer a new mode of user interaction where we use body and hand gestures for more expressiveness. What I have here is a Kinect sensor, and what I'm going to show you is how this Kinect can detect my body pose, and therefore offer a new form of input
to our autonomous system. I'm going to stand in front of the Kinect and put my arms up here in a calibrating position. What you see on the screen is there was a moment when my figure on the screen was in calibration mode. Then it started tracking me, where there's now a skeleton imposed on top of this mode. So if I move my body around, you should be able to see the skeleton tracking my body as well. So the advantage of using this Kinect is that we can use gestures in addition to speech. For example, if I want to say, go over there to that trash can, or go over there to that computer, these gestures offer additional information to the autonomous system, and it could possibly allow